Blackstone Audio presents Guaranteed Pure, the Moody Bible Institute, Business, and the Making of Modern Evangelicalism by Timothy E. W. Gloege. This book is read by Jim Manchester. For Lillian and Eleanor. Introduction. The face of modern marketing in the early 20th century belonged to an old-fashioned Quaker. Consumers across the United States could purchase Quaker pharmaceuticals, lace curtains, and men's negligee shirts. They were wooed with ads wryly depicting Quaker maids sailing the high seas atop bottles of rye whiskey. But all other efforts paled in comparison to the Quaker Oats Company, a sophisticated pioneer of promotion. It had spent millions of dollars since the mid-1880s to make its smiling Quaker trademark synonymous with breakfast food, guaranteed pure. Members of the Society of Friends, the real Quakers, were not flattered by the attention. In 1916, they sought legal protection by a bill that outlawed using religious names for the purposes of trade and commerce. The Federal Council of Churches, FCC, an ecumenical group representing most major Protestant denominations, also threw its support behind the measure. Together, they argued that the commercial use of denominational names stole goodwill from their religious owners. Surely the country's moral guardians deserved the same basic protections that secular businesses enjoyed. Not surprisingly, the corporate attorneys for Quaker Oats vehemently disagreed. Legal precedents were clear that any word, sacred or not, could be used for commercial ends. Thus, they argued, the bill was an outrageous government overreach, confiscating a private asset, their 30-year-old trademark, over the hurt feelings of a small sect. These business arguments held sway in the hearings that followed. "My sympathies are with the religious institution," Representative John M. Nelson insisted only halfway through the proceedings. "But under the Constitution, we cannot take away property rights." The measure died quietly in committee. In Chicago, Henry Parsons Kroll celebrated the outcome. As the longstanding president of Quaker Oats and a major shareholder, the bill's demise preserved his substantial financial interests. Yet whatever his material interests and disregard for denominational sentiment, Kroll was no enemy of religion. For the previous decade, he had quietly worked to advance a particular type of evangelical Protestantism, soon christened fundamentalism. He had already developed an institutional headquarters for this religious work at the Moody Bible Institute in Chicago. More recently, he and his allies had organized a full frontal attack against liberal Christianity in a publication called The Fundamentals, A Testimony to the Truth. These projects drew from Kroll's business techniques and raised the hackles of denominationally based conservatives and liberals like the current president of the FCC, Shaler Matthews. How fitting, then, that these parties faced each other again over a bill seeking special protection for denominations. In more ways than one, Kroll's religious and business interests were thoroughly intertwined. This book explains how a faith like Kroll's developed during the previous 40 years and came to thrive in the 20th century and beyond. Between the Civil War and World War I, a group of corporate evangelicals created a new form of old-time religion that was not only compatible with modern consumer capitalism, but also uniquely dependent on it. Leaders of this network, spanning two generations, included key participants in the fundamentalist movement. Some, like Kroll, were pioneering innovators in business. Others worked as professionals before entering into full-time religious work. Still others were ministers who exchanged their seminary training for a faith more relevant to their parishioners' workaday lives. Whatever their background, they all held the same ideological convictions, all embraced the individualistic, religious assumptions of what we call evangelicalism. They held a set of ideas about self and society that were common in business. And all...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.